Every curious mind has lots of unanswered questions about our universe and celestial bodies. So, let's begin the question answer session.
Sir, I wanted to know, what is the universe made of?
So, the universe is largely made up of hydrogen and helium. Well, actually, the universe is largely made up of nothing. And within that, we have concentrations of hydrogen and helium. And once you get enough concentration of hydrogen, it'll start to clump together like a planet or a star or something. And it'll form a star. And within that star, you get different elements, like higher order elements in the periodic table. So primarily hydrogen and helium and very small quantities of everything else, carbon, sulfur, whatever, lithium.
In terms of energy itself, the hydrogen and helium we talked about is actually a very small fraction of what is in the universe. In fact, the visible matter that we see in stars and galaxies only forms 5% of the total energy content of the universe. There is something called dark matter, which is another 25%, but 70% of the energy in the universe consists of something called dark energy, which is something that we know very little about, other than the fact that it seems to be indicated by observations. And the reason why I talked of energy when you talked of the composition of the universe is because at some level, as you might have heard of the famous Einstein equation, there is a correspondence between mass and energy. So very often astronomers simply talk in terms of either mass density or energy density and use it interchangeably. So 5% visible matter that we all understand, 25% dark matter which we don't very well understand, and the 70% dark energy which I think we know very nothing about.
Sir, you said that the universe is mostly made up of nothing. So does this nothing mean vacuum?
Yes, that's what I meant, sorry.
So can we conclude that the universe or the dark energy was created from a bursting of a star, a single star, or the elements which are present in this space were from a star, a single one?
No, there are two different questions you asked.
Yeah,
in that.
Yeah.
One is the explosion of the Big Bang. It had nothing to do with the star. In fact, we don't even know what we mean when we say there was an explosion of something.
Yeah.
We just know that there was, as I said, the explosion is only inferred from the expansion. So we really don't understand, and present-day physics can't really quite explain what it actually means, the Big Bang explosion. The explosion of a star is a more, it's a better understood thing. We understand much of the physics of the explosion of stars, which caused the elements to come out and form us. That we understand in a much better manner.
Thank you, sir.